السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا كثيرا كما أمر، والشكر له سبحانه فقد وعد المزيد لمن شكر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان ورضوان ويقين إلى قيام الساعة والدين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. My dear respected brothers and sisters, it is again another blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us to be in one of His masajid, in one of His houses on earth. As you all know, masajid belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they are His houses. And it is promised from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that whoever visits Him will be given a gift. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala definitely will give each and every one of us by going to the masjid to pray a gift. How about if you choose to stay to visit Allah longer and connect between two prayers? The Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Anta fi salatin ma dumta tantadiru as-salah." The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "You are in a prayer, you are in ibadah, as long as you are waiting for the salat." So all of us right now, even if there is no dust, are in some form of ibadah. And subhanAllah, only in the masjid, that it is not waste of time. Only if you are in the house of Allah that you are not wasting time. If you are doing nothing, just sitting. So may Allah make us among those who يَعْمُرُونَ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, indeed, they are believers in Allah in the Day of Judgment, those who fill in His houses. And may Allah make us among them, inshallah. Before I go to the, inshallah, third part of our series of fiqh al-sira, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the fiqh of the biography of the greatest man that walked on earth, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I would like to invite you all brothers to attend this, inshallah, and sisters, to attend this upcoming event at the University of Houston, inshallah. It's called Refuge in Revelation. To seek refuge in revelation, in wahi, mainly the Quran and the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inshallah, the brothers who are organizing this activity, they told me if you don't let the money scare you from attending. You know, sometimes when you see that there is an admission fee, you may hesitate. Said, if you can afford, fine. If not, please just walk in and you will be welcome to attend this program. It's going to be at the University of Houston from June the 11th to June 13th. Inshallah, after a month from now, inshallah. Less than that. So before you leave, inshallah, please pick one of these cards, beautiful cards, mashallah. Now we go back to our journey with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Speaking about the birth of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam demands from us, all of us, to speak about his lineage, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. We cannot talk about the seerah of the Prophet, peace be upon him, before talking about where he comes from. And how important is that in the life of every Muslim, male and female, to understand? Because he spoke about his lineage, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in many ahadith that are, alhamdulillah, documented in Bukhari and Muslim and other great books of seerah and sunnah. Now imagine with me a place, all what Allah said about it is wadin ghayr diza, a valley where nothing goes. And a man and his wife and their baby are traveling in the middle of nowhere in the desert. Suddenly, this man stops and tells his wife, stay here. And he leaves her with some water and some dates. And he says, I'm going back. إِنِّي مُهَاجِرٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي. I'm going back to Allah. And when he leaves, he doesn't say where he's going. And this woman is Hajar, our mother Hajar. May Allah be pleased with her. And this great man is nobody but Ibrahim alayhi salam, our father Ibrahim alayhi salam. And their baby is Ismail alayhi salam, as all of us know. When he's leaving, she insists on asking him, where are you going? He doesn't answer. Ibrahim alayhi salam doesn't answer. She asked him three times, where are you going? And then she told him, Allahu amaraka bihada. Did Allah order you to do so? He turns alayhi salam and he said, yes. Allah ordered me to leave you here. She said, فَلَنْ يُضَيِّعَنَا أَبَدًا. Then go. Allah will not waste us at all. This is al-yaqeen. This is a form of al-yaqeen. Certainty of a woman who believed truly in Allah and trusted her husband. Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he left, before disappearing in the horizon, he looked back and he saw his wife Hajar alayhi salam sitting with a baby. Nowhere, no water, nothing, nothing, not even a building, not even a house. And then he made a dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala documented in the Quran forever. Quranan yukla ila qiyam as-sa'ah. It's a Quran that is being recited till the day of judgment. And this ayah is amazing to understand, my brothers, because usually people start with what? Usually people start in terms of their needs, they start with the physical needs. Water, food, that's basic, we know that. That's why everybody works. But Ibrahim alayhi salam, this is the mentality of Prophet. And the awliya of Allah, the awliya, the friends of Allah think like the Prophet. They don't think about the material world before they speak about the spiritual one. Because they know everything material, including your body, will disintegrate back to min turabin wa ila turab, back to earth. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, subhanallah, what did he say? He said, Rabbana inni askantu min dhurriyyati biwadin ghayri dhi zar'in inda baytika al-muharram. He said, oh my Lord, he turned to Allah and he said, Ya Rabbi, I have brought my wife and son in this valley where nothing grows, nothing grows. Which later on became Mecca. Nothing grows up, nothing. Not one single plant. And then he mentioned, subhanAllah, he said, عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمُ. This is another proof of the people who say that the Kaaba was there before Ibrahim alayhi salam.